It's 2015, this year's Pi Day will be awesome. Also, after 2 years of maintenance, repairs and upgrading, the Large Hadron Collider will start up again. They've shut it down after they discovered the Higgs boson and they've made it even more powerful. And this leads us to a familiar question. Could, by any chance, the Large Hadron Collider create a black hole that could destroy the Earth? They were worried back then, imagine how worried they'll be now when they find that the Large Hadron Collider is twice as powerful than before. No, LHC cannot create a black hole. Even if it could, it would be so small, so tiny, that it would evaporate in an instant. So we don't have to worry about that, for now. But what if it could create one? For example, they managed to create a black hole the size of this ball. For the sake of the thought experiment here, we're gonna ignore the fact that a black hole of this size would be much heavier than the Earth. Let's say that somehow, even though this is a black hole, the densest object in the universe weighs the same as this ball. What would happen? Surprisingly, a lot. First of all, black holes aren't holes per se. They are spheres, just like the Sun and the Earth and almost everything else. The boundaries or the top layer of this sphere isn't solid. You can go inside of this sphere. That top layer is called the event horizon. When you pass that point, the gravity becomes so strong that nothing can escape out. So, if this ball is a black hole and if you were to touch it, it would cut your finger off. It wouldn't devour you completely because black holes aren't cosmic vacuum cleaners. No, as long as you stay away from the event horizon, you'll be okay. And this creates something here, because anything that touches it, anything, will go inside and never come out. So you can't really hold it in your hand, really. You can't hold it anywhere. If scientists were to create one, it would go straight down, right through the concrete and dirt and rocks and molten iron. In about 15 to 20 minutes, it would go to the center of our planet. And it would continue going to the other side and back again, until it gets so heavy that it stays in the middle. And for a little while, we wouldn't notice anything out of ordinary, everything would be fine. Up until the black hole sucks up all the molten iron in the center of our planet. Then the mantle and the crust wouldn't be able to support themselves anymore and they would collapse right on top of the black hole. And that's it. In just a few hours, maybe, the whole planet would collapse in on itself and it would disappear into nothingness.